estudiantes. Como padre apoyamos todo esto, las injusticias que pasan en otras escuelas. Gracias.
Let me ask you this question. What is the definition of a school? An institution where the youth goes to obtain an education. In other words, where us young people go to learn, right? But how are we supposed to learn with all these metal detectors, secure school safety officers, and cops in our school? I mean, when I wake up in the morning, the first thing I say to myself is, oh great, metal detectors. Waiting in a line bigger than lines outside of amusement park to sunrise really sets my day off with a negative vibe. And security guards, I myself have been harassed for bringing a pair of scissors. What really grinded my gears was when a security guard emptied out my bag thinking I had a cell phone, which turned out to be a calculator.
Let me tell you that I was a New York City public school teacher for 25 years before I got elected to the New York City Council, and I know firsthand that the issues that you're talking about are what's happening in our public schools, unfortunately. Now, I taught fourth graders, a little smaller than this young man over here, but I know from many of my friends in high school where you have these metal detectors about what really goes on in the schools. I can't imagine, because my school didn't have it, my elementary school didn't have it, but I can't imagine how degrading it is to every day have to walk through one of those metal detectors. And part of the reason why we have to have this culture is because one of the young women here was wearing a very interesting t-shirt, and it said, I don't know where she is, but if she's still here with us, it said 3,000 guidance counselors, 5,000 school safety agents. Is she here? Can you come over here for a minute? Because this really speaks to what the problem is in the New York City public school system. If we had those numbers reversed or even increased, where we had 10,000 guidance counselors to work with our students, to prepare our students for college, rather than creating a police state when you walk through the door of a school and you have to be shaken down to see if you have anything inside of you, then maybe we would have more success as well. So that's really, 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 to me, what the issue is all about. We need to fund our schools, we need to find discipline measures that work with our students.
But at least I know education is more important than money. Land of the free, if this was utopia, we'd have to see each other naked. Before we got married, but instead we'd see each other all naked all the time because the government has my social security number and the name of my dog. Then we make babies, but don't worry, we won't be left behind. They'll grow up saying, God bless America. But they won't know who Bush is because they never learned the presidents. They will ride the ship Amistad to our dreamland shores, bearing the same shackles as us. I'm here to say that Generation X is pissed and we are taking over, ripping down the American illusion of perfection. We are the future generations. I have my qualifications. I know it sounds like angel soft paper, don't worry, it's a diploma. Do I look qualified? You can take our toilet paper, but you can't take our revolution. Let us stand together. Stand against the push-out. Let us use restorative practices such as justice circles and open the lines of communication. We are the next generation, and the generation before us worked hard to get us into these schools. And we want these schools to be perfect and equal, give us the right education and the right learning environment that we need. So that students can actually learn and go into a field where they can actually be productive and do something great with their lives. Not just sitting at home doing nothing and having to sit in the streets, because we're tired of that. A lot of times people complain that there's so many youth in the streets, but why are they in the streets? No one ever asks why are they in the streets. And that's because a lot of times a lot of these teens are being pushed out of their schools and they have nowhere else to go. So that's why we want to stop happening. We want these students to be able to stay in their schools and finish their 4 years and go into colleges. Yeah.